This podcast is hosted by truly horrible individuals. It contains vulgar language and the discussion of horrific and sinful topics. Quite frankly, it's not appropriate for anyone.
What's up, everybody, and welcome to Twist of Insanity, episode 8. Did we settle on 8, Kelly?
Yes.
I don't think that's a debate. I think that there's a finite answer to that.
So my name's Kitty.
I'm Kelly.
With me is, there we go. And we also have a guest today, Lyle, also known as Guitar Master X7 or Lyle McDoucheback.
Okay, that's more in the last decade.
Your channel is still Guitar Master X7, isn't it?
Yeah, but I try to bury that as deep as I fucking can.
Okay, this is Lyle. Not Guitar Master X7, but Lyle McDoucheback.
I've been doing this since I was 14. Give me a break.
So, as usual, we have a mega delay, and now there's three of us, so you're just going to have to get over the fact that we're probably going to be talking over each other and about random shit. And
as whatever. Generally happens when I come in here, everything gets worse. But this time, it's kind of not my fault. Well, we'll see how the rest of the night goes. Still time for me to ruin it further.
Yeah, so Lyle, why don't you tell us like what you do to the people who don't know you?
What I do to the people that don't know me? Oh, Jesus. I mean, there's no accountability there.
I am for accountability.
Jesus Christ. She warned me she was just going to walk me into a bunch of politics before this started, so.
Kitty always does that.
Oh, yeah, boy.
So, doom and gloom.
Actually, what I do, I do cartoons, I do music, I do goofy shit. I am the harbinger of giggles. Anything that makes me laugh or that I want to do or that I don't want to do that'll make you laugh, I'll do that. One time I yelled at the Big Bang Theory on Twitter and it got like 60,000 retweets, so that was a thing.
Oh, wow.
I have a few videos that regularly get stolen and posted on Facebook, so if you've ever seen a silly cartoon where a grandma touches semen and melts posted by a page called LolXDFunny with like a billion views, I did that even though my name's not on it there. That's very specific. That's how you might know me. Or maybe you just know me. Who knows?
They probably all realize they know you now.
Yeah. So if you've seen something vulgar, crass, whatever, that wasn't done by myself or Kelly, with loud, shouty man, it was probably Lyle.
Anytime someone says a swear word, it's me. I take full credit.
That would be, could you imagine if you could like get royalties on cussing?
I'm sure that I've come up with terminology that, like, I probably could. There's certain things like the term, like, fart tangler or something like that that I've come up with. Fucking, vagoblin. I've created some homebrew horribleness that could probably be copyrighted, but I'm putting out Creative Commons on that. You can all use them. Go for it.
So, talking about your grossness and horribleness. I can't talk tonight. You're just going to have to get over it. Obviously, we do an ad read near the beginning of the episode, and we gave Lyle the product to read. I'll do mine next week. For Lyle, we gave him this beautiful Real Doll treat off Amazon. And if any of you are interested, there's a link in the description. We don't get anything from it, but we know you're going to love it. So these are dolls that are made to look like real babies. And this one is staring into
That is fucking horrendous.
All of the pictures were like more worse than the last. Printer.
Yeah.
I don't know where you fucking found this, but you found a way. So that's a thing.
Kitty was looking for a baby.
So just I'm doing an ad read? Is that
just you?
We rotate
each week, but because you're the guest.
Okay, fair enough. I'm the guest. I've got. Let me see here. One sec. Professionalism. I do it sometimes, but not right now. So
for those of you who are new, we do a fake ad for a real product every week, and that's why we're throwing the guest under the bus.
Cool. So whenever you guys are ready, I can start.
Go for it.
Okay, cool. Let me just get everything up here. Ladies, are you tired of waiting to experience the gift of motherhood? Is your biological clock ticking? Do you drive off every man you meet because you're exactly the kind of fucking psycho who would buy a disgustingly hyper-realistic replica baby? Introducing the disgustingly hyper-realistic replica baby! Using our patented... what is that? What the fuck technology? This eerily real replica baby looks like it nightmarishly crawled right out of the uncanny valley. Wow! Seriously, wow. Looking for the perfect gift to keep that special pedophile in your life out of jail? This disgustingly hyper-realistic replica baby is 100% certified BILF by a quality assurance committee of registered convicted kitty diddlers. And then my phone shut off, but I have a testimony.
Okay, Mr. Panicky, I would like you to take a look at this picture.
Oh, heavens, yes.
What do you think about that?
It's a beautiful child. I would love to...
Quality,
I would love to touch it. I would love to kiss it on the mouth.
Oh.
May I see the child again?
No, you may not! Order disgustingly hyper-realistic replica baby today and get 15% off your eventual one-way trip to Oregon. Just use the code I am now mentally ill enough to qualify for assisted suicide at checkout. Disgustingly hyper-realistic replica baby. Why, mommy?
Why have you done this?
That's the
brilliant.
Product.
That was epic.
That's the
brilliant.
Product. That was.
There you
I'm
go.
Clapping quietly for all the headphone users.
The baby does have there nice long
well,
eyelashes.
It is horrific.
Just
looking at it, just like, yes, I'm beautiful, aren't I?
You're gross.
I was halfway considering saying the full name of the Amazon product, but that seemed fucking impossible to actually do a full read on because it's NPK Collection Reborn Baby Doll Vinyl Silicone 22-inch 55-centimeter Babies Doll Lifelike Express Toys Girl for Children Gift.
Gotta get all the search terms.
Wait, this was for children?
I guess that's exactly what it's called. I just read for you verbatim exactly what it was called.
I watched a documentary once on people that had these dolls, and there were legit women, often like grandparent age, that had entire nurseries set up for these real-born dolls.
Did they like take care of them?
Yeah, they would take them out shopping and things like that, and they all had their own clothes and names and birthdays, and some of them had bodily functions and would breathe and cry, and they could be thousands of dollars and super realistic. This one isn't realistic. This one was just creepy as fuck, and that made me laugh.
It's right in the center of the uncanny valley. It's just real enough to be really creepy, but not real enough to be convincing.
You could pull it off in some pictures, probably.
Look up everyone who's listening. Look up real born doll and just do an image search. And some of them look creepily real, and a lot of them will breathe and cry, and I don't know, there's probably ones out there that piss and poo as well.
I saw...
Sometimes I go down delay. I didn't mean to...
Yeah, I saw a woman who miscarried a child, and she kept the fetus and was, dressing it up and posting pictures of it.
Is that the one where the fetus is dressed like Snow White?
Yes! Yes! You know what I'm talking about!
I've seen the Snow White fetus!
Yes!
Yeah! In fact, Kitty said that I couldn't do miscarriage jokes in that.
Yeah, that was my limit, was miscarriage jokes.
That was the first thing I asked her, and she said no. So I'm glad you took it to that place, because I wanted
to. What is it with you and your fascination with fetuses?
Well, I know, I just saw that on Reddit, but yeah, someone posted on her Facebook, she put the picture of this fetus dressed as Snow White, and one of her friends is like, what is that? And she's like, it's my daughter. It's really sad. That's really fucking sad.
It's funny until you realize it's real and there's someone out there that genuinely needs help.
Yeah, and the amount of like pain she's going through, but in the moment, hilarious.
That would start to like stink too. Like it would smell like, really bad after a while.
Yeah, its face was pretty foul.
I imagine it smelled bad from the get-go.
I was gonna say before we got into fetuses, I sometimes go down like internet rabbit holes, and I just remembered this like a long time ago. Me and a few friends, we stumbled across these people that were like, it was like they were really into real dolls. We like found this weird sub forum of like real dolls. And this one person's real doll was like a bunny. Like it was like a like an anthropomorphic bunny, but it was full human sized, and he would like take it outside with him and like ride on the bus with it and shit like that. It was horrific. It looked like a pretty much like a mannequin in like an Easter bunny costume, and he would put like he would put fishnet stockings and shit on it.
Ooh.
And yeah, he would take it around and like he would post about how rude it was for people to stare at him and shit like that. And it's like, what the fuck do you think? But they're like, that guy, like, okay, the weird thing is they're like so committed to it that they refuse to admit that it's not like a real
thing.
They
treat them like real people.
Like, exactly. But I mean, you've got to fucking know, like, even if you're completely psychotic, you've got to fucking know that if you're like dressing the thing, that
especially
it's not
a rabbit.
Like, yeah, that's the weirdest fucking part. And he, by the way, he never acknowledged that it was a rabbit at all in the post.
Barry's like, gone wild.
Never, never came up as a topic.
I've seen people that have them as like girlfriends. I don't know if any. I haven't seen any women with them as boyfriends, but I've certainly seen a lot of men like documentaries and stuff where they've had them as girlfriends and would dress them and sleep with them and fuck them.
Yeah,
and
there was this one.
There was a YouTuber.
Go ahead, you go ahead.
Like married a real doll. Was that what you were gonna say?
Oh no, I had a different story about one.
No, there's like a YouTuber that had so. First, this guy had, like, a girlfriend that he had, like, social media and everything for, and he talked shit about this model who had a bunch of plastic surgery, and he was like, you're not a real woman, you're this and that and the other, and she was like, all right, and she, like, reverse Google image searched his girlfriend, and it was, like, a Korean model that he was, like, taking all these, like, pictures from, and just... But he was running the social media, so it was super, like, weird and sad. And then after that, what he did was he was in a relationship with another girl, and she was, like, a real doll. Like, she was clearly a real doll. Like, all of her pictures would, like, have her phone right here so you couldn't see her face. And then he got an actual girlfriend who looked pretty much nothing like the real doll, but... Then they just kind of played it off like they'd been the same person the whole time. They were like, oh, yeah, that's her. What are you talking about?
Wow. It's
the same girl from the pictures.
That sounds like my kind of messy
really
YouTuber.
Fascinating. Yeah, it was interesting.
How did I miss this? It's epic.
I don't know if I want to, like, throw the exact person under the bus.
Yeah, don't, but do tell
kinda,
us after.
He's kind of bigger, though. Let me just say that. It's not like this, like, unheard of, like, 100-subscriber guy. It was, like... I think he was bigger. I don't know if he's still big by today's standards, but...
Wow. Yeah, no, I feel bad. Like, you know, whenever I see of these people that have these fake girlfriends, whether it's through having a real doll or just fake, I feel bad for them that that's what they're doing. And all that time and effort they're putting into creating this, like, fakeness, they could actually be, like... on match.com or something, meeting people.
But some of them in, like, those documentaries, they try to get girlfriends and they just prefer the real dolls.
Yeah, that's weird. Did you see...
Because the real dolls can't sass you.
Well, yeah, you can just slap them without paperwork. Yeah.
What? Hold on. Is there paperwork that you can get to slap your girlfriend? Did I miss
no,
out?
No, what
on
I'm
this?
Saying is you can like assault a real doll if you beat a woman. There's paperwork once you get arrested.
Oh, okay. I thought there was like a form you could do to like apply.
I wonder if there's attachments to make a real doll like scream. If you hit it with enough force, it goes off and they scream.
I was actually talking to a buddy about this. It's like in making like sex robots and stuff, like you've got to, there's a huge gap between just like making a thing that's like a mannequin you can have sex with and something that's like real, because, you know, if they're not crying, then it's not realistic. So yeah, I'm sure there's somebody that has like a real doll that they like have an abusive relationship with.
I'm pretty sure they have like different probably attachments for like the tongue and the pussies, so you can really
switch it up. Yeah. So Lyle, there's hope for you. You get different attachments.
Right on.
The weird one to me, like, that doesn't even freak me out. Like, I don't know. But the ones where the guys dress up as the dolls, like the women dolls. Have you seen that? Let me see if I can, like,
I think maybe if you're talking about what I think you're talking about.
What are they called? Like rubber dolls or something?
My friend had this guy that he kept fucking linking to me that's like a, it was like a dude that would wear like a mask. It was like a realistic like woman mask. And then
I'm talking about like these. Hang on.
What?
Yeah, is there a person under that?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much exactly what it was.
Yeah. Those freak me out. That was another documentary I've watched. But there are like other ones. So they look like dolls. They don't look.
Yeah.
But there's a guy in that.
Yeah. That was pretty much exactly what it was. It was always him like dancing to some fucking like Goodbye Horses ass shit.
Yeah, and actually, I think I've seen this.
Full body, because they have a suit.
Jesus fucking Christ.
So those are the ones that I find very strange, because I don't understand how there's so many. Like, I think I could understand like a couple, but there's hundreds of people that do this. And, you know, I don't think it's that they want to be female, because you don't need a mask and a fake bodysuit for that.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? The internet is home to lots of very strange things. I remember
lonely people too.
This is yeah, exactly. This is like some like basic bitch ass shit, but I remember when I first discovered the internet and like the Sonic the Hedgehog porn, which is fucking huge.
That's a thing?
Oh my god, do you not know this?
Dude, everything is a thing.
I'm not surprised that it exists. What I am surprised at is how much of it there is. There is like so fucking much of it.
You
Google anything sexual, and like by like a little bit scrolling down, you'll get to Sonic the Hedgehog pretty fucking fast.
There's like these kids games.
It's really
where
strange.
Where you spank Dora the Explorer. They have a baby spanking game. That's on kids' websites, though. Those are on kids' websites, but
yeah, those are like those weird like Indian company ones.
Yeah, they just pretty much repeat the same games over and over.
Those are a little less like weird sexual things, and that's just like a foreign company kind of trying to just be like, let's make the same game but with Frozen Elsa. You're talking about like
shit, Sonic the Hedgehog porn is real. I just Googled
it. It's not only real, it's very prominent. I'm actually surprised you haven't. I know! How have you not come across it by accident? Have you not Googled like any weird shit in the last 10 years?
Like, porn just doesn't do it for me. Like, I don't look at porn. Like, I'm weird.
You don't even have to look
up
porn.
Yeah, that just gets like posted randomly. Like, you'll see it scrolling through Twitter
it's
sometimes.
I've missed it, because I had no idea. Like, I knew about, like, tentacle porn and stuff like that, but I never knew little Sonic and...
Sonic the Hedgehog porn is so prominent.
Wow.
It's so weirdly prominent.
There's
that's the part of it that blows me away. I'm not surprised that it exists.
Blew him away in one of these pictures as well.
I saw one horrifying one. I follow a Twitter account called Bad Sonic Fan Art, and, I saw one, and it was like Shadow and Knuckles, but they were like flesh toilets. Like, their faces were like African lip disc, like stretched out, but they were like flesh toilets, just full of piss.
Oh.
Just fucking weird shit like that. It's so
That's
disturbing.
Horrific.
There's a Shadow the Hedgehog x Shrek fan fiction. That was a big one that blew up. Again, this is pretty basic shit if you're into like the weird internet.
Welcome
like I am.
To
oh,
Will,
there's Death Eater
porn
from like Fallout.
With your co-host.
Oh, there's gotta be.
Yeah, there is.
Yeah, no, there's tons of it.
Wow.
Yeah, pretty much any video game character you can find porn made in source filmmaker of them getting fucked by dogs or some kind of other like big animal.
I wonder if like Pornhub or like X Hamster or anything has like Trump porn, like someone fucking a guy who looks like Trump.
Yeah, see, this is what I thought.
Because I imagine that could be a real moneymaker. Like, especially
yeah,
if it was,
after
like,
that,
BDSM.
After that PeePeeGate thing came out, like, they should have jumped on that immediately.
Yeah, I mean, I was
done,
looking
like,
for
a,
it, and I couldn't find any, so someone needs to, like, fill yeah. that demand.
If I was in charge of Pornhub, like, on the day, I would be calling as many people as I can to be like, okay, we need two lesbians pissing on a bed and someone that can do a good Trump impression to jerk off in the corner. Boom.
Yeah, totally. Like, if you are a Trump impersonator, first of all, apologies. And second of all, porn. You need to get into it. Violent stuff. Pissing on beds thing. Like, it's not
too
late.
Speaking of politically charged porno, do you guys remember, like, that weird period of, like, 3 months where everybody wanted to fuck Sarah Palin?
Oh, yeah, no. They made the porno...
Yeah,
and then Tina Fey, people
Palin.
Were liking her
I seem
too.
To have just like got these huge, huge gaps in porn, apparently. So educate me.
No, there was like a weird like 3 month period when, you know, John McCain and Sarah Palin were running, where everybody just kind of wanted to fuck Sarah Palin. And then it went away pretty fast after. It was like a very 15 minutes of fame kind of thing. But yeah, they made a porn called Nayland Palin, and I think that was like a springboard for that actress's porn career. But
oh,
yeah,
that's
no, it was
sad if he looked like Sarah Palin.
She doesn't really look like Sarah Palin, but
okay.
You know, a lot of Sarah Palin is like the glasses
like the
and the hair.
She's really
she's
the
like
porn
brunette.
Star version,
like
big
you
boobs.
Betcha.
Yeah,
and the face is similar.
Yeah, I seem to again have missed out on this.
Yeah, that's like one of those like things where it happened but nobody brings it up anymore. It's like
it's
truck
a good
nuts.
Reason.
Like what the fuck happened to truck nuts? They were like everywhere for like a month and then they were just gone.
No, they're still there.
Are they? Well, you're in
yeah,
Georgia.
We have,
yeah, I don't
exactly.
see them around.
Like, we have
Chicago.
A big truck stop.
Maybe in
yeah,
southern
I,
Illinois.
I remember seeing them like everywhere and then all of a sudden nowhere. It was weird.
Yeah, they're still here, but I mean, it's the South, y'all, or something. However they say it. So, porn, great. I just can't get over the topics we've covered so far.
Would you like to watch some with me? Would you like to...
No, I wouldn't.
That's your homework, Kitty, is to explore the world of porn.
Explore the world of porn.
And give us
so
a report by next podcast.
You know
okay.
you're depraved when you're like, when's the new porn coming out? I've run out of porn on the internet.
I don't think that's even possible to run out of porn on the internet, is it?
Oh, it's unfortunately possible.
Oh, dear.
This is the next topic. Dear. Just move on.
Yeah, yeah. Instead of talking being fucked, I guess Trump is now officially president. We didn't do a podcast last week, and a shitload has happened. And Lyle is a huge fan of politics. He loves it so much.
Yes,
talks
let's,
about it
let's
all
have
the time.
Let's have the guy who makes the cartoons where they what say the fuck word. Let's have him weigh in on politics. Everyone
the first
listen
one.
All.
It's sad. Like I was like that. We have lots of small topics, but they're kind of major. Like. It's sad when, like, the second day in office, he removes the Federal Housing Association's, like, insurance on mortgages, so it increased, like, I guess, like, 850,000 people's mortgage overnight, but now...
Was that the second day? I thought that was, like, an hour within being sworn in, he
yeah,
did that.
Yeah, that was it, within the first 24 hours. But now that story is the size... It's like this. It's nothing compared to the other shit he's been doing.
Well, there's so much going on. The Dakota Access Pipeline, that's back on. What else?
Oh, but that came later. Before he fired all the foreign U.S. ambassadors and has no plans to replace them. And after he did that, he put a government freezing ban on new staff members, so they can't replace them. Any non-essential for non-homeland security stuff, whatever. Now the Dakota Access Pipeline... he's targeting Obamacare. Like, there's just we have just so much that he's just fucking up, and his press secretary is hilarious. Have you seen that guy?
Yeah, he's
the inauguration crowd. You're lying, and I so like how offended.
Has he even acknowledged, like, that huge protest, or was he just, like, bitching about the crowd size at the inauguration? Because that's all I saw.
All he's done is bitched about image stuff. There was something else on the BBC News. I didn't write it down because it was just before we were filming, about the press secretary. So he was talking about how everyone's lying about the stats of, you know, Obama versus Trump. And then he got some stats, but it was from the 2000... the latest Obama inauguration, which was when 2012 versus, you know, 2009. So he was comparing like the second inauguration with Trump's first, and it was just a mess. Like, he just had no facts. He was just making up numbers. And then I think the same day they had a female representative on the news, and they were discussing it and how the press secretary was very aggressive with it, and she's just like, you don't understand, it's alternate facts.
Yeah, alternate
yeah, that
facts.
Was actually a term they used, is alternate facts.
Alternate facts, yeah.
I mean, I can get my tinfoil here and say that maybe this strategy is, it's kind of like what they did with the, like when he was running. Because a lot of when he was running, it was all like, oh, look, he said a goofy, mean thing. Look over here. And meanwhile, he's just like, I don't know why we can't just use nukes. Why can't we just blow them up? Or like being asked, like, he got asked about the nuclear triad and didn't really seem to know what it was. Things like that. Yeah. Like, that was what worried me about him. Not that he, like, said a racist thing. Or
no,
that
I think,
he, you know.
We're all talking about this ridiculous press secretary because he was like, no, his penis is bigger than everyone else's. And it's so easy to kind of get sidetracked like that. But while that was going on, he was doing some real shady shit. So I just worry, like, that the press really have to be on the lookout for what he's doing while his press secretary is comparing dick sizes.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, he went
and
to the CIA.
How much you
want to
bet they're focusing more. They're focusing more on the dick size stuff. Oh, he went to the CIA.
Yeah,
and was
Trump.
Like, look,
he was complaining about the inauguration numbers.
It was huge.
And how the media lied about it. And then most recently, now he's complaining about how he didn't really
lose the popular
vote.
What? What does he want the CIA to do with that? Like, go to CNN and I don't know, maybe do like the Men in Black flashy thing. You guys have those?
Probably. Yeah.
he was going at them out. But I feel like we have like a 5-year-old child in office because he's so brash and so irrational in his stuff. Was it yesterday he started targeting abortions for international aid foundations? So people who receive international aid are not allowed to perform abortions if they want to keep it.
If they want to, well, no, you can't.
Like, if they
want to
keep the aid
too. I mean, what do
I've
want?
Had
another
4 hours
Snow
of
White?
Sleep.
Please, no more Snow Whites. Please, no.
You probably saw that Snow White homunculus fetus and was like, "No, we got to stop this. Build a wall about this. I don't like it."
Like he tweeted out, like, going back to the inauguration. He tweeted out a picture from a photograph company that pretty much, like, shows the best view possible from his inauguration. Just to make a point, like, he can't drop it. He doesn't want to take, like, real numbers. He's just like, I'm right and no one else is. So that's it. But he's just going on and on about it. In the meantime, he's signing stuff that is basically saying it will give you financial aid to the countries who need it, but if you dare promote abortion or perform an abortion, we're going to take that aid away. He's doing that, then he's firing people, putting walls up around the EPA, and then planning one around Mexico.
You can't just have Donald Trump as president and not have him fire people. That's what he does. That's what he got known for. It's firing people.
It's so scary.
I guess the argument
Kelly
against
save us.
Aiding other countries and the abortion thing is, should we be funding other countries' abortions? That's what I've seen thrown around. I don't know. I'm just pretty much for, like,
it's
the more babies
one.
We kill, the better.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like,
it's a weird one. Like, why do we have the right? Like, if a doctor thinks that a woman needs an abortion, why does some guy, you know, thousands of miles away, have the right to determine that? Surely a doctor is more qualified. I think that's the thing, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I guess people are just going from the funding perspective that those abortions are happening because they're being funded by the U.S. or whatever. But I don't know. I also read that we don't fund
abortion
over in other places and not in this country either. I don't know. Just
if
what I was looking at trying to find
hanger,
the
you can,
argument against it.
You can pick it out, no problem.
I knew you were gonna like crack a coat hanger joke. Like I knew it. I could see it in your eyes. I was like queuing up. You knew exactly.
I think it's a woman's right to choose. I think after she pushes it out, she has at least, like, before they slap its ass, she should be able to, you know, say, hey, just put it up on the light and smack it like a pinata. I changed my mind. So, and that, you know what that costs? It costs nothing.
Wow. Okay, so we all know where Lyle stands.
You can do a water birth and then just leave
abortion.
It in the water.
Post-birth abortion.
These things don't have to be costly. It's like the death penalty. There's people that are like, oh, the death penalty is so expensive. It's like gravity is free. Just push them off a really high thing. What are they going to do? Sue you when they're dead? Who's going to know? How do you know we even do the whole lethal injection thing? How do you know they're not just pocketing that money and just, you know, that's it?
Wow.
You know there's no gold behind our money? Do you guys know
that? We're fucked. but the sad thing is, as brash as that sounds, you'd probably make a better president than what we've got right now.
It's efficiency. It's what I advocate.
Streamline everything.
Yeah, exactly.
But wow, I don't even know
Yeah, I'm trying to think too. I guess the punching Nazi thing.
I mean, I have more ideas for how to run things.
All right. How would you fix healthcare?
Okay, so if you're sick, okay, the cliff is free. We've established that. So when I say free healthcare,
are you gonna go like Man in the High Castle route and just burn everyone on Tuesdays?
Well, I mean, Tuesday's a bit early in the week, don't you think? Wednesday's Wednesday's the day you really need to pick me up. That's when you got to burn the button. Anyway, yeah, let's move on to punching Nazis, because
yeah, what's his name? Richard Spencer, is it?
Yeah, it's Richard Spencer.
So he runs a very alt-right party. He's very pro-white man, traditional marriage-type guy. Very, very, very traditional conservative with a huge swirl of racism thrown in. He was talking about the Pepe the Frog meme and got punched in the side of the head on national TV.
Just the fact he was talking about Pepe the Frog and he punched.
Yeah, he's talking about memes.
It's the meme magic.
I don't advocate. I'm a pretty, like, pacifist person when it comes to violence and stuff, but when I saw him get punched in the face, I did laugh.
I laughed too.
Yeah, it was hilarious. I watched it like 4 times. I was like, that is karma in action.
Today, people are making, like, just adding music to it, and that's making it a lot better.
It should be pointed out that the dude is maybe not a literal Nazi, but he does, like, go around, like, throwing Nazi salutes and, like, fucking with people. Like, the way that I see him is he's kind of like the, like, I'm not touching you kind of guy in like, middle school and shit. You know, the guy that would get up and you're, ooh, I'm not touching you, I'm not touching you. So when he gets punched as a dude that's like, oh, yeah, look at me, I'm such a Nazi. Look at, fuck you guys, no one's going to do anything about it. Like, when he gets punched, it's like, okay, that's funny, because it's like a literal Nazi that's fucking with people getting hit. So on that level, it's funny to me. I like that.
I watched a couple of his YouTube videos like a few weeks ago before he even got punched, because he started popping up in the headlines and everything. And, you know, he was just talking about a safe white world.
Yeah. And, see, okay, here's the thing about that, though, is I don't trust people's intelligence enough with that kind of, because, okay, like, for example, I saw people saying, like, you shouldn't hit somebody, like, you shouldn't resort to violence against speech, because he's not attacking anybody. He's saying controversial things, whatever. Which is fair enough. I respect that viewpoint. Again, I think more than making actual, like, speech claims and stuff, he's just fucking with people, and, you know, you do that for long enough, it's eventually something's gonna happen. But the thing is, I saw people say that, and then those people who were like, yo, this is like free speech and you just hit a guy, they were then called Nazis. So I've seen a lot of people on, you know, that side throw around like the term Nazi and this and that and the other. So I like that that particular guy got punched, because he, again, he's fucking with people, right? Yeah. Like, it's a matter of time before it happens. But the precedent that it does set, and like where those people kind of draw the line with what a Nazi is or what a racist is or what hate speech is, because sometimes, like, I mean, the fact that you can be like, okay, that's his First Amendment right, and they're like, that's hate speech, it's like, uh-oh, all right, where are you drawing the line now? Where is a Nazi to you? Because a Nazi to me is a dude that throws fucking Nazi salutes and says Sieg Heil in rallies and fucking talks about white-only communities and fucking, you know, racial purges. That's a Nazi to me. But, you know, people saying, maybe this isn't racist, maybe this TV character isn't racist, that's a Nazi too to some people.
I think he is
people.
Racist.
Oh, he's racist. He's definitely racist.
Yeah, yeah, but I think
it's very,
speech,
like, cut and dry, like, hate speech, this and that and the other. Like, the guy is definitely, like, a provocateur, but he's definitely a huge raging racist. Like, I don't think it's a stretch to call him a Nazi, but
he's certainly,
again,
a Nazi sympathizer, if not full-blown Nazi himself.
Yeah, but again, I don't really trust the kind of people that generally draw those lines, again, because I've seen people that, like, anything that isn't like a super hard line left stance, I've
is
seen those
Nazi
kinds
bigot.
Of people called Nazi bigots.
Yeah,
yeah,
you see
exactly.
That all over.
So that's why, because I've seen people, like, I have a couple buddies that do, like, political type, you know, commentary and stuff like that, and I can understand where they're coming from. Now everybody's saying, oh, look at you crying over Nazis, and they gotta understand, it's like, these people have been called Nazis for going, hey, maybe don't punch people, you know? So it's,
yeah.
I don't know. I see why people are going, hey, maybe not. But in that specific occasion, that particular dude getting punched was like, oh, okay. If he had gotten shot,
like,
or something, or like even brutally beaten, then it would be a little more, whoa, okay. But yeah, he just kinda...
I would have preferred it to have been a slap round the face, because I think that would have been funnier. but I think we're going to have enough problems protecting free speech with Trump in office. Like, we don't need, like, violence against people who don't agree with you. I don't agree with
that
guy, but he does have
true.
A right to say it. Also, while I don't condone the violence, I wasn't sad about it. I thought it was funny.
Me neither.
I watched it a few times.
No, I wouldn't say go out and punch that guy. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying I'm not sad that he got punched. I'm not going to debate. I'm not going to debate the ethics of like punching that particular dude, because again, I think that he's the kind of person that when he goes in and he does what he does, should probably be expecting to get hit just because he's intentionally trying to get people riled up and emotional.
I'm surprised Milo hasn't. Has Milo been hit yet?
I don't think so.
See, I think Milo's a troll. I think Richard Spencer believes everything he says, but I think Milo's just a troll. A very educated troll.
And the thing about Milo is he's also, like, he's a bit of an asshole, but he knows, like, where to kind of draw his line. Yeah. Like, Milo doesn't go out and, like, advocate for genocides or something. Like, he'll make some, like, racially charged comments and stuff to, like, rile people up.
I think every once in a while he says some pretty wild shit.
Oh, absolutely. But even if you take everything... Yeah. Even if you take everything that Milo says absolutely 100% seriously, you don't really get a Nazi out of it. You get a pretty big asshole out of it, but you don't, even if you like completely disregard the humorous aspect of him just trying to wind people up, like he doesn't go around like advocating genocides or saying Hitler was right or anything like that. Now, I'm not super familiar with Spencer's shit, but I have seen the video of him throwing the Sieg Heil and shit like that. Like, if you take him seriously, you do get Nazi out of that. Like, you get literal Nazi out of that. But that's the thing, is, like, people draw the line of Nazi, you know, pretty arbitrarily, and especially, like, the really, really far-left people. They even draw it. I've seen, like, Dave Rubin. I don't know if you know who that is. I've seen him called, like, alt-right and, like, Nazi and stuff. And he's kind of like a left-leaning, like, classical liberal pundit. So, you know, is he now fair game to these people? I don't know.
I think politics has almost become like an extreme sport. Like, if you agree with, like, if you voted Hillary, regardless of whether you liked her or not, but you are now a leftist, social justice warrior, nut job. And if you voted Trump, you know, or you wanted Trump, you are now a right-wing fascist bigot. You know, there's no, you can't just be like, well, I agree with this of X candidate and this of Y candidate, but I'm not really agreeing with either of them on this issue. That doesn't happen. I feel like politics has become an extreme sport.
Or is that just the vocal minorities where the people on each, you know, far left, far right, they're just the loudest?
Yeah, I mean, I thought both Hillary and Trump were just awful.
I think that's probably part of it. It's definitely like the really, really loud minority, but I will say that loud minority does sometimes include people with influence and does include.
Oh, definitely.
You know, it. That's.
So
I didn't think
when Trump got elected, I didn't think he would be that bad. Like, I didn't see it doing any more damage than Hillary, right? And then I started seeing his cabinet picks, and I was like, okay, this is horrifying. You know, you've got the anti-EPA guy going to run the EPA. You know, he doesn't believe in climate change. You've got half of Goldman Sachs now running the country. You've got Betsy DeVos, just a complete knob jockey, who donated like $200 million to the Trump campaign or the Republican Party.
DeVos is
educating.
A fucking moron.
Well, the good news is they've asked for a second hearing for her. I don't think they're under an ethics problem, because I guess her whole family is in the education business or something.
Which is fascinating, because the woman doesn't seem to have two brain cells to rub together.
But yeah, we're fucked. Like, Tom Price, what's he running for? I can't remember. He was just insane. Remind me, Tom Price.
I don't know that one.
Yeah, you're on your own here, Kitty.
I do not know that one.
We shouldn't have. Yeah, he was a complete twat. My notes say knobhead.
But, like, even with all these, like, all these different people coming in, I want to go back to, like, people like the Spencer guy. where they just have these huge audiences on social media, and you have Trump saying that, you know, the mainstream media is fake. And then you have the mainstream media who's also screwed up and has reported things that they've sort of bended the truth. And then people see that, and then they start to question it. But then you have all these social media, big social media, people just start following them because they're like, oh, we can trust these people. You know, because there's always these truth and fake being found, like, thrown around by everyone and just dumbing down what truth is, yeah, dumbing down what fake means.
You've seen a big boom in, like, the Alex Jones following. Alex, they're making the frogs gay Jones. have you guys seen that video of Alex Jones talking about fish people and weeping?
No.
And he was like, I have a friend in the CIA, and he told me this story. They have fish people in tubes. And they reach out and they try to touch you, and they feel, we are screwed people. He's like weeping.
Buy these pills.
I love Alex Jones.
I think like everything's become so extreme and so blown out of proportion, and there's enough shit going on for that not to be a thing.
Well, that's what gets attention, that's what everyone like loves
who's
to bitch lately.
Who's that chick off The Blaze? Who's that chick off The Blaze? Is it Tammy or Tony or whatever? She's like one of the most viewed media outlets in the world right now.
I have no idea. Yeah, I don't know.
So Tommy Lahren, The Blaze is a very Republican website.
Oh, yeah, that girl.
You go to it and there's like 60 pop-up. And she does like final thoughts. And she just screams angrily.
She was like trending last night. She kicked Shane Dawson out of somewhere for being gay or something, or something happened. I swear, I look online and he's been kicked out by that chick.
Is Shane Dawson gay, or is he just Shane Dawson?
I don't know the specifics. I think he might be bi.
I genuinely don't know
specifically, but I don't know.
Yeah, so her name is Tommy Lahren, and she just screams at the microphone.
I'm not one to talk shit about people who just scream at the microphone.
Yeah, but she that's true. That's pretty much all you do. But she doesn't crack dick jokes. She doesn't make you laugh. So, you know, you're far more qualified. This is her, Lyle, just in case you may have seen one of her videos.
She's blonde, though.
She does a segment called Final Thoughts. She is blonde, yeah. I'm not a big fan of blondes, but she's very passionate, and she just screams about people. but that's becoming the new media. Just angry white people screaming at microphones. Oh, not necessarily white people. There are some really angry black people.
I mean, there's
a
demand for it now.
And but that's the problem.
It's fucking CNN's fault, really.
News is becoming like reality TV.
I am, by the way, so I made a video called The Trumby, and if you've seen that video, you can probably surmise that I'm not a huge fan of the guy. But the things that I saw him criticized for, again, were like, there were so many places to hit him, and they were like, oh, look at this one kind of rude thing he said one time that has nothing to do with policy. Let's run 43 stories about it. So if you were a Trump supporter and you saw that, you got it pretty deep in your head, like, do not trust the media, because you saw them just blow these stupid little things out of proportion. And even as somebody who didn't really like him, it was just like, fuck, like, hit him on something actual. Like, stop
harping
on
this. Yeah, he'd done enough stuff.
Like, even like the grab him by the pussy stuff, like, even as like outrageous as that was, like, it didn't really have anything to do with anything. It was like 15 years ago, and it was like something he said unpublicly to somebody on like a hot mic, and it like, I've said worse things as jokes.
Yeah,
I've said worse things as jokes on this podcast.
That's for
sure. So it was like that that overshadowed like anything he said about anything after that. And it was just like, fuck it. So
I almost wonder
whether
he's deliberate. Like, there are media conspiracy like theorists out there that's like, he's releasing this stuff, like, he's leaking this so that it covers up what he's doing. Like
the grab him by the pussy thing came out like when his tax returns were starting to get really big, and then he was like, "Grab him by the pussy," and then it was like nobody cared. Nobody cared about his taxes.
I think
this podcast was almost called "Grab him by the podcast" until Trump became president.
You missed out on those relevancy clicks. That would be a relevant name for the next 4 to 8 years, or maybe two if he gets impeached. Who knows?
But it became a bit too serious when he became president. We're like, oh, it's not funny anymore.
Wouldn't want to take this podcast seriously. What's the next completely dry political topic we have on the table? What are we going to talk about next?
Oh,
are we
going to
talk about
puppies.
The socioeconomic implications of Trump's new energy? Whatever.
The drowning dog.
Did you see the TMZ or TMZ video of a dog's purpose, that German shepherd that they were trying to get into rapid water?
Yeah, I did.
And then it like nearly drowned at the end. I don't know, my gut instinct when I saw that video, for those of you who don't know, it's a trainer trying to get a dog to swim through rapid flowing water on set. You know, it's not like a real lake or a river or anything. You can look at it. I'll put a link in the description. But this dog just doesn't want to go in at all. And he's kind of, well, we don't really know. Like the camera cuts are really weird. Like,
yeah, I mean, I've given a dog a bath before.
Yeah, and it's a similar thing, right?
React like that. And that big cut does leave a lot to kind of be, you know, filled in. But as bad as it is, even if it's like the worst thing that it is, like Milo and Otis, they fucking threw cats off cliffs multiple times till they got the right take. So it's progress at least. Did you not know this?
I didn't know this either.
Milo and Otis, like the oldish kind of like dog and cat cutesy, their buddies movie?
No.
Okay, so it was a movie from, I think it was actually made in like the early 70s, but it was a Japanese movie and they kind of Power Rangers it over to the West. So the original like Japanese guy who made the movie was like psychotic. So there's a part where like the cat falls over a cliff. So they like threw a bunch of cats off a cliff to like get the tape. God. There's like parts where the cat or the, I forget which animal was, it had to be limping, so they like broke its leg so it would like limp around. They fucking straight up like throw a dog to a grizzly bear because they had to have a dog encounter a grizzly bear. Like it was fucked. But yeah, no, I mean,
oh,
technically
God,
progress.
Man. You are full of sick fucking knowledge in your head. Well,
at the
I
end
ran
of that
out of porn. We established this at the beginning of the podcast.
So you went from porn to animal.
No, we established it at the baby, I think.
Yeah, the baby. We opened with the fun ad. But no, I don't know. There's too many cuts in that video for me to tell. Like when I get, you know, I have a Belgian shepherd, and when I get him used to stuff, it's a bit of time and you slowly work up to it.
I feel like a bathtub is one thing, though. That was like a deep, like, pool with, like, rapids. There's, like, one scene in the video where they, like, loop him in and he just kind of disappears. And then at the end where there was, like, a cut, the video, the dog is just kind of in the rapids, like, underwater. And they're trying to, like, save it.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so the fucking thing was against, like, a blue screen. So they're going to do all that digitally anyway. Couldn't they have just fucking digitally done the rapids? Like, why did it have to be moving water? What? That's the part of it that makes me go, what? Why would you do that?
Yeah, it's weird.
But
they
needed it to go under a little. there were some animal trainers, though, that were kind of arguing back and forth. And I guess because you never really see him, like, shove the dog into the water, you just kind of see him, like, dunk it.
Yeah.
Some animal trainers were saying that he was like putting the dog's feet in the water so the dog could see that the water was warm. But yeah, there's like a fucking massive cut in it. I'm not saying that it's fake. It could very well be real, but there's also the fact that it was filmed a year ago and it's just coming out now. So I don't know.
Yeah, they've put an investigation in, and do bear in mind, like German shepherds and Belgian shepherds do kind of like get thrown out of planes attached to soldiers and stuff, like, in war. Like, there's, like, dog harnesses for paratroopers and stuff. Like, for real.
I know exactly what... It took me a while to, like, mentally picture that the right way.
Oh, dog harness! I have to remember with you two. Okay, so imagine a dog strapped to a man's chest in a non-sexual manner, being deployed out of an aircraft, usually in a combat zone.
I got there eventually.
Bestiality harness.
I imagined it more like a supply drop, like German shepherds incoming.
Oh, so it wasn't...
Or like a carpet bombing. Yeah.
Yeah, I was kind of wondering, like, are the dogs on their own and they have their own parachute, or, like, are they attached?
They're just attached to their chest. Yeah.
But I just imagined, like, a dog strike. Like, they drop, like, 50 German shepherds behind enemy lines.
I thought you were going, like, the bestiality sex harness route. See, I thought, like, 10 stages worse than you.
You were being the pervert. No, I mean...
Yeah, I was thinking about it physically. Like, you can't fuck a dog in free fall. I've tried. It's incredibly difficult.
Well, there we go. Tried and tested by Lyle. So, fuck. What are we going to do? Oh, what else? We've got tons of shit here, but I don't want to discuss
any of it. Like I said, what are we
going to
do? Like, that changes everything.
Like, what are we going to do?
And this now, stop recording right this instant.
Now that we can't fuck a dog in free fall, I don't know where we go from here. All of our plans.
We go off the cliff.
Completely out the window. They go off the cliff as virgins and land as virgins at the bottom of the cliff. Dead dog corpse virgins.
I'm staring at you.
The bags under its eyes are really buggy.
Yeah, it's really creepy. Like, it has bags like me.
Yeah, that baby's seen some shit.
Babies are kind of like, babies are fat, though. They got all that, like, squishy. Extra stuff and squishiness and rolls and...
I don't want to talk about anything serious. There's so much.
Didn't we have, like, nice news? Like, wholesome stuff?
We had a couple of things, but everything's been kind of Trump-washed.
I mean,
we had
on how you look at it, like, a global-scale apocalypse is, you know, could be a good thing. I would welcome it. I want this shit
like
all glass as much as the next
humanity.
Guy. No, just like a shutdown of humanity. Just turn it off. Just end us.
The National Park Twitter is, like, it's been going at Trump. He's gonna, like, come at them, and then eventually they're just gonna, like, you know what? Yellowstone... Super volcano.
Yellowstone
it can go right
off
now.
Some fire
Who gives
tweets.
A shit?
When Yellowstone becomes a nuclear power, that's what we're headed for. That's the singularity.
Oh, I saw another.
Wouldn't that be ironic?
I saw another.
Yosemite was the one to launch the first nuke.
I saw another video where there was like a probably like 35-year-old and above guy. Standing outside of a high school with a Trump sign, yelling at all the Mexican students leaving, saying they were going to be deported. And from what the school said, they were like, we can't really do much because he has his free speech, but he was in their parking lot. I don't know why they... I don't know. They said something like that.
Yeah, he's in their parking lot.
Yeah, here's what you do. You one of the parents should go to Home Depot... and pick up, like, 12 Mexicans and just have them build a wall around the guy.
Yes.
He's built a... Trump's already, like, done a media blackout on the EPA and put a freeze on all their grants and fundings and all of that. So it looks like the Environmental Protection Agency is going bye-bye, probably along the ways of the National Park Service with their little Twitter beefs going on. It was
Can
so
you
petty.
Tweet
like...
a national park out of existence?
I don't know.
Yes,
he's gonna
we're
try
about to find
to.
Out.
So what happened with the inauguration pictures?
They
like
have
the
worst
comparison?
Squirrels, pathetic squirrels, sad.
We got to get rid of them. Like the National Park Service tweeted out or retweeted a comparison of the two inaugurations of Obama's and Trump's, and then they got taken down, and then they were put back up and made to apologize for it.
Oh.
And then, yeah, they went on another rant today, but then they had to delete those tweets as well.
What was that about? What was that about? I missed it.
I didn't see it yet. I haven't read them.
Well, that was...
It was just trending as
There's
we were starting.
There's just so fucking much.
It's just so annoying, like, the focus being on the inauguration numbers. Like, no, who that's not relevant. Who gives a shit? It doesn't matter.
Yeah. It's literally... That's why I think maybe it's a distraction.
Yeah, it
because
is.
Because they're talking about it so hard, and they're like, oh, it's such a big deal to us. Meanwhile, Trump's like, yeah, I've got things to sign.
Yeah, and it was like that throughout the campaign. The more they started lying, the more you knew they were hiding.
It was, it's really worrying. Let me see here. So
well,
we have...
It's hard to find. It's hard to hide things in this day and age. Like, distraction is really the name of the game.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, today, Congress has made a move to make abortion more expensive. Well, I guess that's a bonus on making it illegal.
There was another bill that...
all federal workers...
That life starts at fertilization. So it would kind of...
Oh, God.
Yeah, so that would, you know, kill the whole abortion thing, because it would be considered a human...
Shit.
But that's just been introduced, so it's not like they voted on it or anything.
So here's why it's so scary.
I mean,
is a bunch of...
I could step on the thing. I don't care if it's a human or not. Like, why does that word all of a sudden make it off limits? I don't understand.
So federal workers have been told to halt external communication. So there's a media blackout going on in the White House, which is fucking fabulous. And Donald Trump's company is already receiving direct payments from foreign agents right now. This is all news that's broke within the last 3 hours.
But so, why don't we just wait and see what he does? Why don't we just wait and give him a chance, guys?
Well, we have, and he's already destroying stuff.
Yeah, that I don't know. That's just the common thing that I hear. It's like, why don't we just wait and see?
It's all
like,
we can
do. He's doing
do.
Shit. What are you looking at? What are
you
fucking...
Whether we like it or not, it's happening. I mean, you can reach out to your representatives, and you should, and try to have as much of a voice as possible. But at some point, some of the things he does,
I notice a lot of...
have no power over.
I notice a lot of streamers are doing like charity streams for Planned Parenthood. I know Hutch was doing one last week, and I've spotted a few other Twitchers doing it.
No,
I would suggest people donating to that. Otherwise, soon you're going to be going to people like Lyle for an abortion with his.
And I'll do it. I'll do it at great prices.
And you get a free Snow White dress with your fetus. Oh, excuse me, human.
Yeah, the Disney princess of your choice. You can dress up your little wad of human is whatever Disney. Look at my Etsy store. I've got plenty of fetus sized Disney princess. The flood is bad, but as a boat salesman, I can't claim that I'm super unhappy about it. I mean, the nihilism game is I'm in that. I'm right there. So. Business
oh God.
For me.
So why did we make Lyle the first guest or a guest, Kelly?
That's
your
that's
idea.
A good question. That's why you should ask yourself that. You did this willingly.
Just when the audience thinks that me and you are sick fucks, Kitty, we bring someone who's more sick.
I think it's good, right? Because your viewers used to think I was a cute and innocent one, and then we kind of broke that a little bit, but now we bring Lyle in. We're now both the cute and innocent ones, and Lyle's just this fucked up monster. I think this is actually, it may not have been a bad idea to get Lyle on.
Look, I'm not saying that he was right. I'm just saying, you know, he had some good ideas.
I don't even know. Like, I can't.
I didn't say what I was talking about. You guys both just assumed it. Who popped into your head right now? Who just popped into your head?
Hitler.
There you go. Look at the power of suggestion here. It really brings to light a lot of thoughts, doesn't it?
Because we were talking about Richard Spencer. So I'm in the racist mindset right now.
We're talking about Richard Spencer like half an hour ago.
Oh, there was a DNC. I don't know if she's running for something within the DNC, but she gave like a little speech about herself, and she said that her job would be to keep white people quiet.
Oh.
What? I want that job.
Like for the,
I don't want
for
it to
the
be
Democratic
specifically
Party.
For white people.
Just keep them quiet.
Gee, I wonder why so many white people voted for Trump with such great selections as that.
She was white too, which is like, well, then are you going to shut the fuck up?
That's the weirdest thing is like 9 out of 10 times I see like fuck white people, it comes from like some pink haired white girl.
Yes.
Yeah. Like we're fucked, guys. We're just fucked. Like that's there is no climate change. It's all a lie. And we know that because obviously Trump's cutting the EPA, the trans specific partnership that's fucked.
Well, that's
housing.
Good, isn't it? Isn't the trans specific
Yeah, kind of. I think he's
like
just
that,
trying to negotiate
that was one of,
better terms.
To be fair, like that is, I'll give him credit for that one.
So here's what I am hopeful for with Trump, right? Because we could talk for another 6 hours on the negative shit that's happened. I am hopeful for healthcare. I don't know whether he's going to fix it. He could break it. But he wants to remove the walls between the states and put it into Mexico. No.
You got it. You got it before.
He wants to remove the state boundaries for health insurance. So for those of you who aren't in the US, like say if you're in Georgia, like me, you can only buy from a Georgia provider. So you can't use like a cheaper person, for instance, maybe in Florida. So he wants to remove that to drive up competition. He's also been attacking pharma recently on his Twitter, which is pretty brave, even for Mr. Oompa Loompa Trumpenstein. You know, he's been like, the pharmaceutical industry is outrageous. He's been calling out drug prices. And
yeah,
I wonder
well,
if he's going to...
We're the only country that doesn't negotiate those.
Yeah, and I wonder if, and I am hopeful that, perhaps he goes, you know, like a Putin route, you know, where Putin will go to terrible companies and be like, you've got X amount of weeks to fix this and make it affordable for my people, or we're going to take you over.
Putin does some sick judo, too.
Yeah, he does.
Our Senate just voted, they had a vote where we would be able to get cheaper medicine from Canada. And a lot of them, Democrats included, voted against it. And so we can't.
Yeah, that was actually the big thing. That was sunk by Democrats.
Yeah.
Weirdly
yeah,
enough.
Because everyone wants money, right? It's an industry run by greed, and that is bipartisan.
And lobbying,
that's not
just so much lobbying.
A Republican thing.
I don't subscribe to the idea that Trump can't be bought, but he's definitely going to be more expensive to buy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. So since the problem with Obamacare is, right, it was well-intentioned, but it completely negated the fact that we pay the most for medications of any other country in the developed world. And because of that, our insurance is several hundred percent more expensive than the rest of the world. And, you know, we had people that were paying $60 a month for health insurance before the Affordable Care Act. And now they're having to pay $500 or $600 and most likely don't have health insurance because of it. So what?
Oh, no, this is a fun podcast discussion. Go on.
Oh, God. So, you know, something needs to change. And it's the insurance isn't going to get cheaper if the medication stays at the same cost. It's bullshit.
Yeah, the one good thing about him kind of going after Obamacare, which is overall probably not a good thing, but the one good thing about it is there is right now a bullshit part of that where if you don't have medical insurance, they fine you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So if he gets rid of that, that's cool. The rest of it, you know, not so great. But getting rid of that part of it, I'm all for.
I think everyone needs health insurance, but it has to be, like, affordable. And right now, it is not affordable.
Yeah, but they don't fine you and like, force health insurance on you. They just fine you.
Yeah, it's
you.
Like 1% of your income or something. I can't remember.
I think it's, like, a flat, like, $700 or something like that.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah, but it's still, like, if you're broke...
Oh, you can't afford
you,
health insurance?
Yeah, we're gonna...
Here's a fine.
It's kind of like what banks do, where it's like, you don't have any money in your account? Well, we're gonna charge you for not having money in your account. Fucking what? Yeah.
So I am hopeful that Trump has, and I think he will do a better job than Hillary or anyone could have, maybe kind of resetting or working out better deals with medication. Because right now we are absolutely getting fucked and not in an enjoyable way. So I am hopeful that Trump will fix that.
I'm hopeful.
Oh, by the way, speaking of Hillary, I hope she's completely fucking out of the discussion now because she lost. She's gone. People still are
Fuck Hillary. I won the popular vote. We need to just talk about that until everyone agrees that I actually won the popular vote.
Even then, though, it's like, whatever. The Electoral College, it exists. Like it or not, it exists. It's, mm-hmm. you know, open and shut case, whatever. He's the president. But, like, I hope people fucking watch him. And not just go, oh, yeah, well, I voted for this guy, so now I have to cheerlead him because I don't want to be wrong.
And some because people act wrong, like that.
And that's the annoying part. It's like, dude, watch your fucking guy. I would have said the same thing about Hillary. Like, watch what she's fucking doing. Like, but now it's like, well, what would Hillary have done? It's like, that's irrelevant. Who fucking cares? She's not in there now. Pay attention to what the dude in there is doing.
The country and, the election process was set up to question leadership, to question authority. Like, that's why there are those protections there. You have
By
to
the
watch
way,
whoever
I know,
it was.
Sorry, let me just put a little disclaimer after that serious political statement. Go watch my cartoon, Super Mario Smokes Weed XD. It's really funny. The Goomba peas and says wacky weed jokes. You'll love the wacky weed jokes. Okay, sorry. Go back to political discussion.
You're such a dick. You just fucking throw a wrench in every time we're starting to get flow because you're like, fuck politics. Watch my
but
shit.
But yeah, there's so many like cases where whether it's, you know, someone who was supporting Hillary or someone who was supporting Donald Trump where they had a similar issue to each other, like, I don't know, both taking money from like special interests or having like a conflict of interest. And like they would ignore it for the other person, but not for the candidate that they want. And it's like, look, you can be critical of everyone. You don't have to agree about every single thing.
If Hillary Clinton had put somebody from Goldman Sachs in her fucking cabinet, can you imagine the amount of shit that the same people going, oh, why would you just
if
wait
she
and
had
see,
even said hello
throwing.
To someone from Goldman
and Trump,
Sachs.
By the way, has three. Three, not is it three Goldman Sachs or is it five? I think it's three in his cabinet.
It's smart for him to do that, though. It's
for
just
him,
like I just see people use like crazy excuses to excuse something Trump did over Hillary
Look,
doing
Donald
a similar
Trump's
thing.
Rich, he's gonna make me rich. All right,
Donald
That's
Trump's
how
also
it works.
Been like companies have been bankrupt a bunch of times and sued and whatever. Like, you know, like I said, I'm hopeful about the healthcare. I like the fact he's sitting down with the car manufacturers and trying to get money back into Detroit and getting, you know, giving tax breaks and tax incentives to people who are going to manufacture in the US. I think that's really fucking important because too many people are stuck on bullshit burger flipping jobs or, you know, shitty paid jobs. So there needs to be more skilled jobs to come back into the US to start building up money for people because most people are fucking broke these days. I think it was Forbes did an article.
Yeah, people are being paid less and then the level of inflation. There's a whole bunch of issues. I forgot what I was gonna say.
So yeah, I think, you know, economically Trump could be good. I'm hopeful that he's going to be good. I think healthcare, he could be good. I certainly think he can bring down the cost of medication.
I think if he wanted to get some brownie points right now, helping Flint, Michigan would be a big one because Flint, Michigan's had issues
Didn't he just do so long now? No, that's not Dakota Access. No.
Yeah.
The problem is, isn't it the EPA that deals with things like Flint and has just closed them down?
I don't know if he'll do that, but if he did do that, that would be, you know, okay, there's a step forward.
But he's not. Instead, well, actually, that would be a good thing to do while he reopens the Dakota Access Pipeline.
I mean, he's talking about infrastructure so much to get that restarted and to start with Flint, Michigan, I think would be meaningful to a lot of people just because they've had so many issues now for so long that just aren't getting solved.
But it won't be because the EPA isn't allowed to talk to the press anymore. So he'd get no press credits for it. You know, but it would be a good distraction while he fucks up and restarts the Dakota Access Pipeline, which, by the way, he personally has stocks in.
I wonder how that, if that's going to get really crazy. I mean, I know right before Obama, you know, called it off, the vets had just showed up to build, like, to build a wall, to act as a wall between the protesters and the police. So it was already starting to escalate.
Can we just go back and say, I called this? Like I said,
I think everyone sort of expected that too, was that, okay, it's fine now that Obama's done it, but like Trump's just gonna reverse it.
Trump's coming, yeah. Trump's coming.
Do you guys ever wonder if SpongeBob SquarePants feels sexual pleasure when he puts things in his porous holes?
I think it's probably feels like a really nice itch. Like, if you have just an itch you haven't scratched in a long time, I could see it feeling like that.
So it's, like, all skin? Like, it yeah. Like there's no, like, internal feeling in that?
No.
Okay, continue.
I feel like we need a Lyle for when we get too intense. Just to go in and just fuck it up. But, yeah. So, hopefully Trump won't fuck everything. But I don't know. I know what's going to happen. No one knows. How scary is that?
I think that's
I find a little bit of a, I don't know. There's something interesting about that. There's something interesting in like just setting this scary child loose in your curio section and just wondering what'll survive.
But that's exactly what it is, right? It's just this irrational, spoiled brat of a child with way too much power. And it's just no understanding of what he's really fucking doing.
So you guys don't want America to be great again?
You don't want a MAGA, bro? You don't want a MAGA?
I feel like I need to be waving a Union Jack right now. I'm wondering which reality TV star we're going to get, right? Because you guys have Trump.
Mark Zuckerberg.
Kevin O'Leary's going for Canada.
It's like...
How fast do you think we're going to get the "you're British, you can't talk about American politics" comment? How many comments in? How many comments
deep
do you think that one's going to be?
Until you just said that. So now
yeah,
imagine there's 50. But I've also been called a Trump supporter and a Hillary supporter. And
yeah, that just comes with the territory when you fun of them. I made fun of Trump for having little hands and being orange, and I made that thing. And I got called like a Hillary supporter cuck. And then I made a thing fucking messing with Hillary because she said Pepe was a hate symbol. Like actually on her website, she says Pepe was a white supremacist symbol. So I made a thing making fun of that. And then I got called like a Trump supporter racist.
Oh, the new term. Like everyone, I've been seeing snowflake a lot from the right, calling like every single...
Oh, yeah, that's come up a lot more.
It's like, all right, that's not
I've seen
it's
cuck
sort of
a lot on the
insult.
Right.
Yeah, snowflake. That's from, I think it's that Tommy Lauren person who came up with snowflakes. I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's been around for a really long time.
Yeah, I think, but she's kind of made snowflake. It more, like, more prevalent, if that makes sense.
Yeah, like, it was like Tumblr snowflakes to, like, now views. Everyone on the left with any possible... remotely left idea is a snowflake.
Yeah, let me just explain how big this chick is, and I'm not talking in size. I don't want to like the page.
You're talking about that pussy.
Yeah, so she has 4 million
pussy.
Likes.
That flat pussy.
And most
hit it
of
with
her
a bat pussy.
Oh Jesus Christ! Why do we? Don't let me get Lyle on again.
Fill it
note?
With a vat pussy.
So her videos get, you know, hundreds of thousands, in some cases millions of views.
That pussy.
You done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Are you still going?
No, I'm done. I'm done.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay. No more about SpongeBob and his... sexual gratification.
SpongeBob could make his own pussy.
See, now she's bringing us back to it. You can't blame me for this.
I didn't do it. It wasn't me. It was all her.
Like, what if every single SpongeBob hole was a pussy? You know, when we're talking about weird porn, that's when I haven't
Maybe that's
seen,
why he's a sponge.
I haven't seen, like, Squidward, like, interwoven with SpongeBob. I've never seen that one.
Yeah, and, like, all these
little... come up sooner.
All those little sponge holes become pussies. They have, like, little pussy covers.
Exactly.
Or he puts, like, fleshlights in them.
Right.
So, Google search what the Hyde Amendment is. So, I guess this just broke. We are a pro-life Congress. House votes to make Hyde Amendment permanent. I wonder if they literally just made abortion illegal.
That's abortion. Amendment?
What is that? You've got to hide your coat hanger scrapings? Is that what it stands for?
Maybe. Maybe
hide,
you won't be
hide
able
like
to.
Jekyll
oh, they voted
Hyde,
to make it permanent.
Like...
This was already a thing. It's
oh,
permanent
yeah. okay.
now
so that,
until like...
Oh, no, this is no taxpayer funding for abortion.
Yeah, that was already
so this
the
isn't
case.
Just foreign aid.
This is
yeah,
us,
but that
we
was
already
just foreign
had that.
Aid.
They just made it permanent.
Oh, okay.
Which I don't think
donate
it's actually
Planned
permanent.
Parenthood or Lyle.
Just... Yeah, donate to Planned Parenthood or the
or
Lyle the Douchebag Coat Hanger Fund.
Or the
I'm a
work
non-profit.
It the
it's all for pleasure.
I don't even know what to do with you, Lyle. It's been fun
I've
having
a,
you on, though.
I've got a big cellophane bag. I'm trying to make it into a beanbag chair. Baby bag chair.
Baby bag. What yeah. are you going to do for water baths, though? I mean, is the bathtub deep enough? Do you have one of these American baths?
Well,
do you
oh, get
have
the,
you
the,
ever seen, have
the,
you ever seen
the rapids
you know,
with
you know
the dog
Orbeez?
That the dog fell in. Get that.
You know what Orbeez are? They're like these little plastic balls, and then you
fill them
with water, and they get bloated, and then they like take up more space, and they look, you know, you can like see through them.
Yeah. That's not going to drown.
Are you
a
not
baby.
Filling in the rest of this?
Oh, God. I just got it. You're a horrendous fucking human being. So tell us, like, have you got any videos coming out soon?
I've got a few that I'm working on. I've got a live action thing that I filmed that's probably going to be a little lengthier, which will hopefully turn into a series. I'm working on that right now. Working on some music stuff. I just had to fucking reformat my whole computer because my music shit wasn't working, so that's still a while off. Got a lot of short things coming up. Just little time killer things. I've got a new one of those stupid Team Fortress animations, probably going to be the longest one that's out so far. So that one's getting worked on. And some shorter cartoons too. So that's what's going down.
Do we are we to expect any SpongeBob porn coming out?
I have
with whatever the other character
for
is.
For all my SpongeBob porn, for all my SpongeBob SquarePants erotic fan fiction, I'm gonna send you an image and I want you to tell me how you feel about it.
Oh really? And we're gonna have to link to this image so people don't feel left out.
I want you to tell me how you feel about this.
Okay.
Immediate emotional response.
Shit, I can't look at it or I fuck up our cameras.
Kitty can look at it.
It's not as bad as I... It's not bad, it's just weird.
Does it warm your heart?
No.
What are you feeling right now?
Nothing.
Do you feel the urges?
I'm cold.
Do you feel the urges to own a hyper-realistic baby?
No.
Because
I'm not
the
most maternal. It's just weird. I was expecting way worse. For those of you who don't know.
That's why I didn't send you something way worse, because I knew you'd be expecting.
I know, I was like, what am I missing in this picture? Like, you want to explain the picture for those who are on iTunes?
It is SpongeBob SquarePants pregnant with Shrek's baby, and Shadow from Sonic the Hedgehog is the younger brother saying, "When will the baby come, mommy?" And
I think I've actually seen this.
Soon, sweetheart.
I was expected. Like, I get really nervous when Lyle sends
links. It makes you feel emotions.
I don't feel anything. I just feel like when I open that up, I'm like, what am I missing? Because Lyle's a sick fuck,
You're missing a heart, Kitty. You're missing a heart.
It's a competitive advantage in being a heartless bitch.
You're like the fucking Tin Man from Wizard of Oz. You're going crazy from the paint thinners.
That's the point, isn't it?
This podcast has never existed. You've just been on the floor talking to yourself the last 2 hours.
The CIA released like millions of documents. Somewhere about like telekinesis being real. And like out of body experiences.
Didn't Trump say he would say what was in? Didn't he say what was in Area 51? He said he would do that if he was president.
Yeah, right. I'm waiting for that. I want him to tell us about that. He said he was going to tell us about like 9/11 and aliens.
Did he?
Yeah, he said 9/11 and aliens.
All right. See, this is the shit you should be holding him to, because I want to know about the 9/11 aliens.
That's really the most important
aliens
stuff.
Aliens did 9/11.
I don't know. I don't... What, though, if, like, Area 51 is just completely boring? Like, there's nothing about it. Like, if he went there and got all the documents and he was like, wait, so this was just where we stored our unused military vehicles? Like, if he came out in public and said, oh, it's a storage facility for unused military vehicles, no one's gonna fucking believe him.
They released alien documents too, but I haven't looked at those yet. I think we're aliens.
Alien documents.
We're just like in a simulation right now.
Us?
I really do.
Just
I sort of
particular?
Am starting to believe the simulation theory.
Oh yeah?
I feel like we're part of a giant social experiment.
We're just a YouTube
control.
One of those prank YouTubers videos. We're just like their little simulation,
yeah.
And that's all
it?
We are.
Is it Joey Salads that does the fake social experiments?
No.
I feel
we
like
find out he's gone.
They all fucking do fake social experiments.
I don't know. I don't really watch YouTube, but
and
I
then,
feel
and
like
then
we're
they
in
so,
a social
then they
experiment.
Say, "What have you done today? I helped a homeless person." Except
that
I
hired on Craigslist.
But it was about the message. But what if I had really helped a homeless person? Think about that one, okay?
The audacity of those fucks. Like, now that's someone who I would like to punch in the face. Yeah. Do that.
Alternative
race baiting videos just... and stuff. Who was it that did the race baiting? Was that Fousey?
I think he did a few, yeah.
A few.
He did a few,
that's great.
Like, change the way you think. Like, he did one where it was, like, a black guy chasing a white guy saying stop, and they stopped the black guy, and then had the same scenario where it was, like, a white guy chasing a black guy,
race
and they
baiting
stopped
was
the
so
black guy
hot
still.
In 2016, so, I mean, I get it.
Yeah.
Did that get you off?
No, I'm just saying it was a really hot topic. There was so much race
baiting. Race
baiting
really got me going.
Where's the race baiting
the idea of a large-scale culture war.
Yeah, that's really, the way you said it was
really
hot.
Really got me worked up.
I didn't mean hot like, oh, I find it hot, but like, you know, the media
Kelly
was going with it.
Race baiting.
The YouTubers
you
were going
up
with
two
it.
Two tabs, one about white genocide and the other one about police shootings, and you're just like, oh boy.
How does cultural appropriation work for you, Kelly? Does that get you off as well, or is that
no? Oh my god!
Because I heard like liking Chinese food is cultural appropriation.
I will appropriate that culture all fucking day long. I love me some Chinese food.
Racist.
Yep. Absolutely. If that's what being a racist is, I will totally.
I think like
some people might even call you a Nazi
chicken.
And punch you in the face because you like Chinese food.
Please don't punch
food.
Me in the face.
Do you like rap music? Because
I mean
not
you're
allowed.
White, so shut up.
I like really cheesy rap music, like Classified, like the Canadian dude. It's like,
but
really
is he
old.
Black? Because if so, you're not allowed to listen to it, and white people aren't allowed to rap.
Even my headphones are cultural appropriation. Look at that.
Oh.
Every time you smoke the weed, every single time you touch it.
Wait, are pigtails cultural appropriation? Am I going to get yelled at?
I don't know.
Anna
probably.
Green Gables. Yeah. of Anne of Green Gables. Oh, I think you're culturally appropriating her.
I've got a tribal tattoo, so.
Oh, shit.
I'm appropriating pretty hard.
That is definitely.
Wow. Cultural appropriation.
I'm just saying, it's not too late to bring back tribes. I want them back.
I think, like, people seem to forget the whole appreciation of a culture. Like, there's a huge difference between cultural appreciation and cultural appropriation. And they're not the same fucking
That's
thing.
That's benign racism, Kitty.
Oh, is it?
Okay.
So am I not allowed to like both Chinese and Japanese food, or do I have to pick one, or can I just
Japanese.
Be...
If you heard yourself right now through the ears of a 20-something-year-old fresh out of college liberal arts major,
That's
you would just be embarrassed. You would just be humiliated at how racist you sound right now.
But what if I had, like, sweet and sour chicken for lunch, and then maybe I went to, like, a Mediterranean restaurant for dinner?
You might as well wear blackface at that point.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You might as well dress up like a gollywog and say, oh, massa massa, that's how racist what you just said is.
You're a literal Nazi. Literal Nazi. So we can punch you.
Yeah, she's punchable.
The title of this podcast is going to be like, Lyle and Kelly make Kitty uncomfortable.
All I said was, he had some good ideas. And Kitty was like, oh yeah, Hitler? Yeah, yeah.
You just disgust me.
That's totally it. Yeah, I am completely racist. I appropriate all the cultures with the good food. I'm racist, apparently.
I think cultural appropriation depends on how you treat the thing, too. Like, if you appreciate
I
the Chinese food
like,
and, like,
Chinese,
thank,
I fucking...
say thank you to the Chinese people for creating it, then you're good.
So if you do, like, Chinese eyes and you say, oh, Misha, thank you, is that what you're saying? That's how you gotta...
Yeah, that's exactly what
I
mean.
I think that's offensive. That's offensive. Please.
Too far.
Just
save me. I feel like I just need this up.
I have that Tarzan moment where I put my hand out on every other race of the world, and then I'm not racist. I just want to get my hood pass from all of them.
Your hood pass.
Well, you're like...
My hood pass.
Since you're dealing with being a white male, isn't like... You just automatically get called racist in some circles.
Yeah, no. It's not even worth it to, like, watch your step anymore. Like, as a white guy, either you're self-flagellating or you get called a racist at every turn. It's like, if you don't take the blame for something you never did, then you're automatically a racist.
But what if you're a masochistic racist? So you're self-flagellating, and
I feel like a lot... See, that's the weird part, is I feel like a lot of them are. A lot of the ones that are like, you know, it's kind of like that the bully who's gay always calls the other kids gay kind of thing.
Yeah,
I feel like
yeah.
a lot of the people that step up and go, excuse me, as ambassador for black people, I have to say that you're being really racist right now. I know how black people think, all right? And black people are really offended at what you just said. And it's just like, what are you compensating for?
Meanwhile,
like,
there's three black people in the room who haven't said anything.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah, and they're just sitting there like, the fuck is this guy off about? And it's like, yeah, black people can't stand up for themselves. That's why they need me. They don't have a voice. And we benefit from slavery. Every day when I wake up, I think about how I benefited from slavery, you racist.
Oh, wow.
It's weird. It's really weird. I feel like a lot of them, like, subconsciously are.
I think there's also, like, professional, like, people who are just professionally angry, like, or upset.
That's true.
Like, you know, they go out of their way to be upset, to feel self-righteous. I see it a lot, especially with, this is going to make me sound awful, but whatever. I see it with a lot of people that are disabled, because they get kind of, you go into an airport in a wheelchair, the first thing the flight attendants does is, you know, where's your parent, where's your carer? They very rarely will talk to you until you make it known that, hey, it's just my legs that don't work. And I see a lot of disabled people becoming complete scary social justice warriors because they're so used to not getting treated like actual people that they go from one extreme to the other instead of just fixing the problem and being like, look, there's nothing wrong with me, I'm traveling on my own. They will bitch about it and just whine and moan and not fix anything and just be professionally offended. Like, you can't crack a joke about your disease, even if it's the one that you have. Like, I've cracked jokes around a couple of people about what I have, and they're like, you can't do that. No, I don't fucking think I'm oppressed. No, I think I'm permanently fucking moody.
Someone should just tell all those cripples to get out of the wheelchair and stand up for themselves.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. You know, it's very easy to get into the routine of being sick. And I think that's what happens. There's a lot of people, I'm not saying that they're not sick, but I'm saying that a lot of people kind of get into that routine of being a victim, and it's very hard for you to step out of it. And it's even harder for disabled people to do.
I wish people didn't get so angry right off the bat. Like the people you're talking about who seem to find like things to be offended about, and then they go for their cell phone to like film someone and like publicly shame them like right away without knowing anything about that person, instead of like just having a
like
civil
conversation.
Humongous what?
Humongous
what? You are pointing to your genitals. You just assaulted a woman.
Sexually assaulted. Okay.
Oh God.
That I wanted to punch it, and I thought that guy was a fucking legend. Like, I mean, I troll people over like my wheelchair and stuff all the time because I'm a sick person with a weird sense of humor, and that's all that guy was doing.
Yeah,
that's all he was doing. I'd have done the same.
It was the weirdest thing about it is it was like a fat joke. Like he was saying he was fat.
Yeah. He didn't even mean it as sexual.
Yeah, it's.
And when he went like this, she was like, oh, you're pointing at your genitals?
Or
you know, like,
was,
if the palms are like that.
There was the Lyft driver with the hula girl.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah. like, people just like go that, out like, of their way.
Like, see, the fact that there's people like that, that's, you know, there's always going to be fucking crazy people. But the weird thing about that is that those people posted these things like, yeah, I'm right. And then, like, all their, like, little circles, like, oh, my God, I can't believe he said humongous. And they were, like, trying to, like, track the dude down. And it wasn't until that, like, hit, like, kind of the mainstream before she started getting torn apart. But, like, none of her friends were like, dude, what the fuck are you doing? You know, like, that was...
I think it's a shock, right? Because she wasn't with everybody from the start of it. It looked like they were very much alone until he started moving into a public area. Maybe they weren't there and they didn't know what had happened. I'd like to think that
the humongous thing, like she posted it on Facebook and shit. And
she had a response.
When it was just people that like followed her, everybody was like, oh my God, I can't believe that happened. Like none of them were like, what are you talking about? It was like complete, total like support.
Yeah, guys, don't just surround yourselves with people that think the same as you. It will be
very
fucking
boring. See, that's the thing that bothers me. I saw so many people on like Facebook and shit, like, if you voted for Trump, remove me. Or there was like a tool where it's like, if anybody liked Donald Trump, it would like remove them from your friends list automatically and shit like that. And it's like, you're never gonna convince somebody that they're wrong. Or even if you're wrong, you're never gonna know that you're wrong if you don't let in other opinions. And I get some people are just total assholes about it. And it's just like, okay, I'm fucking done with your shit. But like at the point where like somebody's actually your friend, which they should be if you add them on Facebook, if you're gonna like harpoon that, because it was so weird. And that's the other thing too, is like the everybody voted for Trump is a sexist and a racist and this and that and the other. It's like you're not engaging with that side like at all, because nobody on that side like thinks that they are a sexist and a racist. Even if they are, there's very few people that will like admit to that, and there's probably even less that like actually are, you know, like it's there's probably very few actual sexists and racists. I mean, I'm sure all of the sexists and racists were in with the Trump crowd over Hillary. Yeah, super predators, who knows? But it's like, by saying you're a sexist and a racist, you immediately put yourself in that person's mind as an irrational idiot, right? And you're not addressing what they actually think. Because the people who voted for Trump, a lot of them fucking thought Hillary Clinton was murdering people and shit like that. There were, like, a lot of Trump supporters, and I'm not saying that this is true or not true, like, I'm just saying a lot of them believe in their heart of hearts that Hillary Clinton was running a fucking child porn ring.
She would have liked that baby.
Out of the pizza shop, right?
Yeah, exactly. If somebody thinks that Hillary Clinton is running a child porn ring, you can't just go, you're sexist, and then they'll be like, oh, well, that makes it okay. You have to convince them that Hillary Clinton is not running a child porn ring, which is easier to do than convincing them, oh, I'm a sexist on the inside. I really don't like black people. Like, it's fucking weird. And I'm not saying one side is right and one side is wrong, because I feel like those candidates were both horrifying for completely different reasons. But I saw a lot of people like that. It was like the full, like, Mandela effect. Is that the right word for it? Mandela effect?
Yeah,
I think so. I have that wrong.
We're in a different, like, timeline kind of thing. The Berenstain Bears.
Oh, no.
Berenstain.
What's the one? The
Dunning-Kruger
one that,
effect? No. Fuck.
You know the one I'm talking about, right?
The bullshit effect. That's what we'll call
it. Where it's like that everybody kind of thought, oh, Hillary's got this. Nobody's saying they're voting for Hillary in polls. And it's like, yeah, because they're afraid they're going to get called a racist. So, yeah, it's like fucking, yeah, you put in the public space that anybody who even touches a positive thought about Trump is a racist. And people that are like, well, I like his economic policies, or I'm scared that Hillary is going to get us into a war with Russia. You're totally not addressing the reasons they're actually voting for Trump. So it's like, who are you convincing? Nobody, fucking nobody, when you remove people. I don't know. Anyway, so Mario Goomba's Smoke Weed Part 2 is going to be the creeper from Minecraft. He's going to come in and he's going to shit himself. And the Goomba's going to say, wow, you just shat yourself. I love delicious shit. And then he's going to eat the shit. And furthermore, when you say that people that vote for Trump are racist, it's, anyway, is that a Dr. Seuss style book about Donald Trump?
Mm-hmm.
That's beautiful. Is it huge?
Nice.
Oh, God. That's great. That's
I actually got this great for Kelly for Christmas, but I never mailed it.
Oh, wow.
So I need to mail it to you so you can have a bedtime story of Trump all in rhyme. It's fabulous.
Wait,
but yeah, always surround yourself.
Wait, I have a topic about potentially fucked up babies. Say Zika
more than
spreads
when Lyle's got hold of them, or before.
And abortion is made illegal. Let's say it spreads to the U.S. Are people just going to be having a bunch of fucked up babies then?
Probably. No, because it's medical. I'm sure there'll be an exception.
Yeah.
Well, actually,
I don't know, though. Zika babies are like gays. They don't count as people, so you can just like scrape them out.
He's joking, guys. But yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
I imagine because that's medical, that should be all right.
But I don't know. I think they went at medical abortions too. People who are really against abortion think you should have like every baby.
That's yeah, I don't know whether they'll, I don't know. It's scary. He's proven to be such an extreme guy just a few days in. So I'm hoping he'll like chill the fuck out, maybe watch Lyle's 420.
How extreme is he? Can he do a kickflip? Can he do a rad kickflip?
Ooh.
All I should say is that Lyle really should start planning an expansion program to his abortion service. Coat Hanger Express, 1-800-COATHANGERABORTIONS.com.
$5 off a Zika baby.
I'm Dr. Scrapes, and this is my clinic.
Dr. Scrapes?
Oh, that'd be so gross.
My God.
If that was you just go to get an abortion, you're already really fucking upset, and then it's just like, I'm Dr. Scrapes. Are you fucking kidding me?
That would be
awful.
Do you
want me to wrap it in aluminum for you, or
or a Snow White dress?
Or do you just want me to put it in the Snow White dress and send it out the door?
I wonder if that woman still has her fetus baby. It's just like a skeleton now. Oh, no. That makes
Maybe
me sad.
Maybe she, like, beef jerkied it, so it, like, dried out.
Yeah. She did, like, a little art project.
In the picture where it was in the Snow White dress, it did look kind of dry.
Yeah, it was super dry.
But I guess the skin cake, yeah, it might just be
that?
A skill.
I'm so glad I never saw this. Like, Lyle, we did, like, an Etsy creepy Christmas gift challenge, and she got me...
It's not for sale.
She got me a fucking mouse fetus in a necklace.
Yeah,
because
one of my search terms was
a
fetus. I was looking for fetus gifts.
I'll show
you
after this.
It?
Yeah, that was my search term, fetus.
Oh, so that's a recent discovery for you, the Snow White feed.
Oh, yeah. No, I didn't find that when I was doing the gift searching. But no,
Kelly has.
That was one of the
fetish,
most hilarious,
the
like, simultaneously, like, disturbingly sad
fetish.
Things I've ever seen. But I laughed so hard when
I first saw
the Snow White thing.
I'm not even going to look
you
it
would,
up.
No,
like,
you
would I'm
laugh.
Probably not going to click.
You don't think you would because it sounds horrible.
I'm going to hit you with it out of nowhere.
No, I'm not. I was just about to say, I'm not going to click a link from Lyle for like 6 months.
Like seven.
You'll click a link from me. I make the topics. I make
this is
topics
why, guys.
On the
like,
podcast
you,
list.
Gotta...
I'll hide one in there as the Snow White baby.
The podcast topics that we barely touched today because Lyle's a dick. No, actually, to be honest, I think it's done the viewers a favor because there's just so much Trump and Stein shit going on. I think you should all thank Lyle for this not being.
I've been trying
political.
To derail it as hard as I can, guys.
You did good. You did good. You stopped my train of thought a few times. And I think it works in certainly the viewers' favor.
It was impossible to stop the Trump train.
I know. This is why, guys, you've got to not surround yourself with just echo chambers of your own beliefs. Like, you've got to surround yourself by people who shock the fuck out of you, disgust you, and debate with you. People don't debate things anymore.
They just get angry and start yelling at each other and, like, name-calling a lot of times.
The weird thing about online debates is nobody really seeks to, like, convince the other person, right? They just kind of want to make the other person look bad to other people.
Like the press secretary with the inauguration pitches. That's how I see online debates.
No, his inauguration was bigger.
Yeah, it's usually either, like, you're a racist. Well, you're a cuck. And it just kind of goes back and forth. Or you see, like, one person, like, desperately trying to explain a concept in, like, cool, collected terms to another person. And then that person is either screaming, you're a racist or you're a cuck at the other person who's, like, trying to, like, get it across to them because they genuinely care, which is just depressing.
It's just, like, that's every time horrifying. I go on Twitter now and start clicking on, like, political things and just reading the replies, it's just, like, fuck. There's a lot of really dumb people. Like, really, really
dumb.
I
like watching...
I'm low-key kind of horrified for when this podcast comes out because I know I'm going to get, like, a fucking essay from I don't know which side because I've kind of been in the middle, which is the worst place to be because then both of them hate you. But
probably,
like,
someone who's had 5 abortions.
Somebody's
going to
take me seriously. Somebody is going to take the statement that I said right before. What if Goombas smoked weed?
I feel like
the fucking gospel.
I feel like we
didn't
need
graduate anything. Don't listen to me.
Our audience is pretty disgusting,
you
though.
You shouldn't be fucking taking advice from me,
Lyle.
Or you,
when
Meryl
Kelly and
Streep,
I
or Donald Trump. Or yep. Who else talks about politics a lot? All of them. Don't listen to all of them. Just fucking try to fact check as much as you can. And, you know, this legal suicide is out there if you look hard enough.
Stop building a bomb shelter.
Start building a bomb shelter or stop building a bomb shelter?
Start,
okay. Start
just
building it if you want to live. Stop building it if you want to die.
Yeah.
Buy gold. Doesn't matter if it's real or counterfeit because, you know, once everything falls apart, they won't be able to
check. No one
will
give a shit. It's just shiny.
Yeah. What else? Jews or aliens from the future?
Oh, I have in my notes that they're lizard people. Well, because I was going to say I like World War II games because I like killing Nazis, but at the same time, Jews are lizard people, so it's like hard to know what side of the fence to be on.
I think it's too late in the game to take you guys down the spirit science rabbit hole, but there is a Facebook page called Spirit Science. And you guys have gone down the spirit science rabbit hole?
I've been down that rabbit hole.
Okay, so for those of you that don't know, quick summary. There is a Facebook page called Spirit Science, and it just posts a bunch of inspirational quotes, so a lot of people follow it because they think it's like spiritualism plus science.
Yeah.
And actually, it's like this batshit crazy dude that believes the world was built by 16-foot-tall Egyptian pharaohs, and that the Hebrew race are aliens from the future that didn't reach Christ consciousness, so they had to come back in time, and then they got in a fight with the Martians. And this is all... It sounds like I'm joking. It sounds like I'm trying to make this guy sound crazier
it's
than
so
he is.
It's so great.
But dead ass, he says that Hebrews are from off-world and they came back in time.
They've started doing
not.
Videos. It's,
I wish I was joking, but I'm not. Yeah, no, he started doing videos and he has, like, a pretty big following, too. And I think most of his following is of people that don't really know what he's about because his thing is called Spirit Science.
Yeah, he's a... certainly grown. I haven't looked at it for ages, like I'd seen it a while ago, but I knew exactly what you were saying.
I found that guy way, way back. I found that guy like when he first started on Newgrounds and he was like nobody. And he kind of started like easing people in and he was like, oh yeah, your chakras and meditation. And then it got steadily crazier. Then it's like, the dodecahedron has fire powers, and if you said it in ancient Greece, they would kill you on the street. And then it was just fucking, there's a giant grid around the world, and aliens make everything, and there are indigo children in China that can lift cars with their minds and put them through walls, and just fucking all of this.
Horrible people. I think it was fun to have you on, Lyle, even if you completely derailed it. I really enjoyed it. I hope the listeners do too. Do you want to tell them your channel? Because you love your channel name so much.
Yeah, youtube.com/LyleMcDoucheBag. You can go to Google Lyle McDoucheBag on anything. I'm that on everything.
Did you actually get it changed over?
Oh, yeah, like 5 years ago. Like I said, I haven't had... Well, you can still get to it for Guitar Master.
Oh, yeah, because that's what I did the other day. But
yeah.
All right, so channel's Lyle McDoucheBag. I feel like we're going to need to put a disclaimer at the beginning of this episode.
Trigger warning.
Trigger warning. Actually, I don't think so. I think we should probably do that on all podcasts and maybe start with this one because, like, listening to a few of us. Fucking stink puss.
I think
and shit.
People, for the most part, will know when we were being sarcastic. Hopefully.
But there's always one who wants to be the asshole.
Yeah.
People are getting really mad that we end the podcast really awkwardly, so I'm just going to continue doing that. So, yeah, okay. I think it's more fun that way.
Yeah. So before we did this, I took like a really big shit.
Yeah, and, you told me about it.
Yeah, I have these fiber gummies. I didn't tell Kelly about the fiber gummies.
Oh, I have fiber gummies.
They're great, aren't
they're
they?
They're so dangerous, fucking good. I always take my fiber now.
Yeah, I take too much of my fiber. That's my problem.
And with that, we're just gonna end.
Get fiber gummies. Seriously, they're good.
Or
pretty much candy.
Dates. These do the same thing.